fun stuff. So we're here to have fun. Remember that. This is not your standard Hare Krishna, fall asleep, whatever. It's a fun program. So, no, Krishna consciousness is fun if we're connected to our needs. So, what we're going to do is review very quickly what empathic communication is. First of all, empathy is being connected with your needs and other people's needs, understanding people's needs and their feelings, and being able to communicate that. That's empathy. Empathy is not fixing someone, fixing yourself, or torturing yourself. It is simply being aware of your needs. And needs, I don't know if you can see the need chart. Where do you need charts? Anything around here? So, according to the philosophy, not only of the mundane psychologists, because we have not looked from the Hare Krishna movement and taken shelter of mundane psychologists, but according to the philosophy presented by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and by mundane psychologists and intelligent people, is that we all have basic needs. Everybody has basic needs. And those needs begin with food, water, air, light, shelter. Because if you don't have those fulfilled, you're not going to move on to the higher needs. Especially, you won't move on to Krishna consciousness. If you can't breathe, how can you chant your rounds? Actually, many people chant their rounds without breathing. That's why they get tired. It's called japa apnea. So if we're always controlled by someone and don't respect someone else's independence, we will be keeping them from developing spiritually, materially, morally, and every other which way. Okay, so that's really important. So those are the basic, actually, I forgot about the most important basic thing, which is self-realization, self-actualization of Krishna consciousness. That is the most important need, but you can't, that's at the peak of the triangle, but you can't get to there unless you fulfill those other needs. You'll be in denial about these other needs and projecting those other needs upon your Krishna consciousness. Projecting means you're going to be thinking you're Krishna conscious, like a sahaja, for example. What is a sahaja? A sahaja is someone who takes something very cheaply, and he thinks he can understand Radha Krishna's conjugal loving affairs, right? Even though he's not on that level. Now, why is he thinking like that? Because he has all those same material needs, which are reflections of the spiritual needs, or the spiritual relationship of Radha Krishna. And he's thinking that those are spiritual, the material needs. So it's confusing because he's not fulfilled. You know, his get basically his wife or his girlfriend ran away. So he's thinking that Radha and Krishna will fulfill that particular need. But it's better he gets married and then she has Hare Krishna at the same time. Anyway, so we have all these basic needs. That's the first thing. Everybody at all times is acting to fulfill those needs. Remember that. If you remember that, you can be empathic with other people. Understanding their strategy to fulfill the need may be horrible. I'm going to give you an example. Okay, here's one of my favorite examples. Who's the... I feel sorry for myself. Nidrahara. They were giving up eating, they were giving up sleeping, right? They would eat maybe a pat of butter every 3 days or something like that, or every 2 days. Anybody here can do that? Can anyone here do that? Volunteers. You will go crazy if you do that. I remember one of my godbrothers, he tried to just eat oranges for 3 or 4 months, and he has a mental problem. You can't do that. So we have those basic needs. We're not talking about pure devotees here. We're talking about the rest of us down here on earth. So, anyway, that's the need philosophy. And to understand, mostly we're going to be doing exercises today. So this is just like introduction, fun introduction, what we're doing. As you notice, I'm not sitting down, because I don't want sitting down while I'm giving the seminars, for several reasons. One, because I like walking around and looking at everybody. And secondly, when you get older, you don't want to sit down. If you sit down, you may stay down. I like to keep moving. So the second part, actually, there's several other things I wanted to mention. There's need philosophy. And then another thing is there are certain things that block communication, which, let me hold that up for you. You can hold it up or something like that. That's not the secret. He's my assistant.
Thank you.
He functions sometimes as a tripod, so. So there's certain things that block communication. One of them is diagnosis. And we just gave an example of what a diagnosis is with Donald Trump, isn't it? You say he's mean, he's a demon, he's this or that. When you give people a name, you just see them as that name. You don't see them as persons, as individuals, as spirit souls. I mean, there is a permanent diagnosis we can give people, or name. They're eternal servants of Krishna. You met us through a boy, did you Krishna Das? Other than that, we are not his body, we are not men, women, or residents, or wherever we're residents of. These are all temporary upadis, designations. And of course, we know that verse, Sagopadi, Ramiramutam, Kapkavapreda, Niramalam, Rishikina, Rishikesha, Sevanamalam, Rishikate. We have to somehow or other overcome these upadis. So when we see people, we should see, oh, there's part and parcel of Krishna. He's a servant of Krishna. He or she is a servant of Krishna. And other than that, when we give people the label, it disconnects us. Like, he is big, he is a rascal. I'm sure we do this often, especially, even in family relationships, you're just an idiot, whatever. So, shouldn't do that. So the second one is denial of responsibility, in which we blame someone else for the situation, for our shortcomings. For example, let's say we eat too much. Does anyone here eat too much? So we say, I'm eating too much because I can't control, this is an excuse, I can't control my tongue. Or I am, I have this disease, so I eat too much. But actually, if we're eating more than is required, we take responsibility for it. So I'm eating more than is required because I'm eating and I'm trying to fulfill something, some other need. You become aware of the need that's connected with the activity rather than denying responsibility. And when you become aware of the need, let's say someone is, just give an example, eats too much, that's not conducive for his health, because the person has a need for love. Because when they were young, their interactions with their parents were such that the meal time or food was the time when they got love from their parents. So be aware of that. And once you're aware of that, you can actually take responsibility and available. Just see Leela Shopping there. There's an advertisement. And she can arrange for you to get a copy of the book. So that disconnects us. And then the final disconnection thing is a demand. Okay, that's what I wanted to mention in regard to the rounds. I mentioned at the beginning of this whole thing that you can become Krishna conscious, or at least you have to become Krishna conscious without having to chant your rounds. Now, the key word in that phrase is having to. Because if you have to chant your rounds and you have that in your consciousness, you're not likely to be chanting good rounds. Because that's energy that you're having to do, you're forced to do it. Like Prabhupada one time jokingly was holding his V-bag, and he moved down the last beam for the 16, and he said, I finished 16 rounds, now I can do any damn thing. I mean, how many of us think, oh, I can't wait until I get my rounds up? Be honest. Yeah, a lot of you. You know, I can't wait until they're done so I can get on, you know, my phone is just screaming to me. I'm going to check my physical page right now. We've experienced that. So many of us have that attitude, you know, because I have the chance to do it. Just like, you know, I go to work every day. I have to cook for that husband who lays. And the husband's also thinking, right, you have to fulfill your duty. Let's be honest, any of you ladies ever hear your husband say your duty is to do such and such? Some of the ladies are scared, but most of them are frightened. So, this demand, so it's not a good energy to have. I mean, I don't want to eat food that's cooked by someone who thinks they have to do it. It's their duty. Ooh, I hate that word, duty. I just hate it. I mean, obviously it's applicable in certain circumstances, but I want, if someone's going to cook for me, then I want someone to do it gladly, voluntarily. I choose to cook because I like it. That's why most of the time, guess who cooks for me?
Yourself.
Me. Because I like it. Prabhupada said, if you cook for yourself, you'll like it and be healthy. So, because it's the attitude. Actually, the attitude of the person who cooks changes the nature of the food. Matter is changed by consciousness. There's experiments like that. There was a Japanese experiment on water crystals. People had, I'm not going to go through it, but people had different consciousness, and the water crystals changed their shape according to the consciousness or the rice. There's another experiment about rice. So, it's the same thing with the job. That if you're doing your job well because you're trying to get it done, well, it's better than not doing it, that's true, but it's not a good energy. So Krishna is thinking, Krishna's a person. The holy name is Krishna. Namachintami Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. So what do you think Krishna's thinking when this person is chanting, just grinding out their rounds? Experience when we chant our rounds constantly. words communicating anything deep. And so more and more, and finally I have to tell this individual, take, you know, close down your Facebook page. And they, that sounds like a disaster. Oh no. How can I live without a Facebook page? What about my friends? What about life? Well, Shanti, oh Shanti, Shanti. You're here. And this person said, wow, I feel peaceful for the first time in so many years. I don't feel I have to respond to all these things. So, in other words, the problem is it is simply the words. And we know communication